on it.
Respected selection committee members, as you all are aware of parliamentary election being held in our constituency on 10th of April, I am unable to present or deliver my presentation in person. So I am preparing this 5 to 8 minute videos and sending you for your kind consideration. Sir, there is a story goes on which I want, which I wish to narrate you before delivering my presentation. A 15 years boy searching for a job. One day he saw an advertisement in a newspaper of a job which suited him. He went to the office of the employer. After seeing a long queue there, he became sad. Giving a thought for a moment, he went to the personal secretary of the employer and handed over a cheque to her to be given to the employer. The lady went to the employer and handed over that cheque to him. The employer read it over and smiled. The cheque, the line in the cheque is like this: "Sir, I am standing last in the queue. Don't make up your mind without giving me a chance. I also have the same request to all of you. After watching my video and giving a consideration, kindly make up your mind. Sir, I have served in different capacities in various tracks as a teacher, educator, you can say. I am senior lecturer. I was senior lecturer in DAT Hapur. I have served as vice principal in DAT Eta, Hathras, Bulandshahr, Gonda. Thereafter, from last 1 year, I am serving as principal in DAT Bulandshahr. As a teacher educator, I realized very early that we lack something in teacher education. Sir, our learners, what we are doing, we have to teach young learners who need basic knowledge of any subject. And the teachers or trainees, we come to us, they lack that knowledge. I have realized this very earlier. But there is a false notion prevailing among teacher educator is whosoever trainees or teacher come to us, they have that fundamental or basic knowledge. So I have made my motto from very early about teacher education is back to basics. My motto is back to basics. We must train everyone, every teacher, every trainee who is going to teach young learners of the basic facts, basics and fundamentals of any subject. You may ask me, what is basic? Just for an example, I am giving you. We are, from last 1 year, we are trying to impart the knowledge of Varnamala in Hindi with correct pronunciation. It is very strange. Sometimes trainees and teachers even object to it, ki they know it. But whenever we ask them to produce it correctly, they commit faults and mistakes. From last 1 year, we are training our BTC trainees of 2012 and making them trying to give them expertise in even Varnamala pronunciation and producing Varnamala correctly, so they could teach their young learners correctly. But sometimes they even now commit mistakes. There is two-way process. First, they have to unlearn the things which they have gained from their teachers, primary teachers, wrongly. And it is very difficult to unlearn things when you are grown up. It is easy to learn, but unlearning is a difficult process which they have to do it before learning these things, learning alphabets, you can say in Hindi. This is my basic concept of back to basics. Other subjects also, we are trying to do the same, imparting basic knowledge thereafter through various methods using ICT, massive use of ICT, you can say. Now, whatever I have done in my dad, in teacher education, I have sent you through email, my write-up, you can go through it for your kind consideration. Now, I must talk about my vision of teacher education. Sir, this is not vision, but we have envisioned, we have taken up it as a project, and through different PPTs, the project which we have taken, we have explained it through different PPTs, which is self-explanatory. You can watch, like, education, what is it about? What is it about? What we are going to in this age in education is the backbone, as you all know. What methods we are using now and what we are going to use. The technology which we are going to use here is, the idea is to convert the hard copy of the study material to the soft copy and load it on our website. So that in the like this block diagram, we are trying to convert the study material in PPTs, videos, which we will upload on our website, and anyone, whoever wants to teach that particular subject, will download it from our website and use it. The whole method is like this. This is conversion. We will use our lab to convert it and then upload on our website, or anyone, whoever wants, will use this mobile technology, which we have projected, inbuilt projected in it, and use it in classroom or at home or for self-study. But the main challenge in this whole process is of constructing the material and conversion of it in a interactive mode. And second one is to enable teachers and make them aware of the technology, how to use it properly. For this, we will need proper IT support and other support, efficient teachers, to create such an not only environment for constructing material also. What we have done till now, from January onward, we have taken this project and we have done what we have done till now is, we have divided the syllabus up to class 3 in different subtopics, and we have given it to different groups to work on it, to prepare PPTs, animation, and insert sounds required, etc. In English, we have already developed PPTs on phonic trails, cursive writing. We also have taken in English another project in using ICT to be used in ICT is identification of 500 words, which will work as a central idea to develop the vocabulary of the learner and to be used properly in the school.
In mathematics, we have already prepared many PPTs and 5-7 minute videos on number system, addition, subtraction and time, etc. In Hindi alphabets, as we told earlier, we have prepared videos of pronunciation and other PPTs on some basic skills. Possibilities. If we use this technology in proper manner, I think we are going to revolutionize our primary education. The idea is to provide and support education to everyone in a fun and interactive way. This is just a beginning. There is a lot to be explored yet. We hope this small presentation has provided a lot of revolutionary ideas and ways to replace the formal teaching to the new modern era teaching. We are very thankful to you. Thank you.